Hello again, gamers. So we've got another title from the publisher Sometimes You, very generously allowed a review code for this on the Switch. It's developed by Goonswarm and was released on the Switch on the 30th of March. And as you can see, the game is called Alteric. I'm not sure if that's the correct pronunciation, but that's what I'm going with. So it's out now on all formats, so you've got Windows, Mac, PlayStation 4, Vita, Xbox, and Switch. So before we get cracking, I'm going to do my usual trick of read you the blurb. You are alone. Are you lonely? You're lost. Or stuck. Somewhere, but where? And most importantly, who are you? Only yesterday you were a man. Today, everything has changed. You died. But your soul is still there. It's a piece of light energy trapped in the alien space between worlds. So we've got a single player 2D platformer with bright minimalistic graphics. I quote, roast your ass gameplay with physics, gravity and logic. You've got two interconnected parallel worlds, a variety of obstacles and dangerous bosses, an atmospheric soundtrack, in-game achievements. Apparently there's trading cards and badges. For those of you that do play it on Steam, it supports the Steam Cloud for your save files, and also has full support for 360 controllers so you can play as comfortable as possible. Obviously for me personally, that doesn't matter because I am rocking the Switch. So let's check in the settings. We've got volume and language settings, okay. Interesting to note, you can't navigate the menus with the I want to say D-pad, but it's not really a D-pad on the Switch, is it? I've got my Joy-Cons in the controller configuration, in the actual controller dock, just so people know. So let's get started. So now you can use the D-pad. Anybody else think that "huh" noise just sounds exactly like Link from The Legend of Zelda? I love how the gateway themes, they're very reminiscent of Lemmings, I think. Ah, I knew something was going to happen. Oh, I didn't quite make it. You see what you have to do there, don't you? Oh, this is clever. I like this. I see what they mean about minimalistic graphics. Yeah, because everything's just squares, essentially. Very, very intriguing setup. I like it. Oh, spikes. Take it, stay there. Oh. Ah, so you press back to hug the walls as you fall. Whoa! There's a save point. If you die, you can... Oh, okay, so there are checkpoints. Oh, no. There we go. No. Oh. Okay, now we're on moving platform territory. This never goes well. I was expecting there, to be honest. Are you kidding? Oh, you swine. Oh, this is going to be difficult. This is going to be hard. So, as far as first impressions go, that was just my own stupid fault. They weren't wrong in the description of the game about minimalistic graphics, but that's in no way a bad thing. I mean, some of the greatest games ever made have been quite minimal with the graphics. I mean, look at Pong. Really, what was that? There we go. Okay, fine. Pong, probably an unfair example because, you know, the graphics were awful on that as a product of its time. Okay. Crafty. Nope. As the world falls down. Oh, I wasn't quick enough. Right, okay, we've got to race it. This is crafty, I like it. I like it a lot. We've got to keep moving. Bugger. One thing I will always seem to say for games by sometimes you, or, well, published by them at least, they're very simplistic, like easy to pick up, hard to master, that sort of thing. Balls. No, screwed myself. Yeah, finish your thought, Eddie, there we go. They're very easy to pick up, but quite hard to master. And the soundtracks are always great. That's not gonna work. No. Gotta go over that second set of steps then, okay? Yeah, anybody that's interested... Not quick enough, didn't press the button. Yeah, anybody that's interested, this is definitely worth a play. I mean, if there's a trial version available, because I haven't actually looked, then go for it, definitely. bit closer to those spikes there.
Whoa.
Booyah! Done.
Whoa.
Okay. Now we're getting into Super Meat Ball and Super Meat Boy, even, and Limbo territory here. Yeah, I didn't think I was going to make that somehow. Clearly got to get up here. Oh, done it, yes. Oh, you swine. Oh, you've got to be pixel perfect, haven't you? Right, if we have this background colour on, it makes those projectiles easier to see. No! Oh! Sorry, I must have, like, deafened people there. Come on, come on. Yes! Yes! Yeah, first impressions, pretty positive. I can see how it could get frustrating as hell. You know, dying on the same section over and over and over again. I can appreciate that. Oh, shit. No! Oh, I knew exactly what I got to do there. You've got to be really quick on the Y button there. Oh, okay. Okay. Well, you've seen the sort of fun that comes into this. Again, you can't use your D-pad for the menus. Yes. Expect a stream of this at some stage, where I try to actually finish it. But for a quick first impressions video, very positive, very positive. It's fun. You know, it does exactly what it says on the tin. It's bright, it's minimalistic. It's got a good soundtrack. And some of the screenshots for later in the game just look manic. I mean, there's lasers, lots of lasers, lots and lots of lasers. And probably moving sword blades as well, and the one where it looks like there's things chasing you. Okay, so yeah, if you like the look of this, I recommend you pick it up. Like I said, expect a stream from me at some point, but for now I will say farewell, and I'll see you all either on the next video or on the next stream. And I will see you all soon. Take care, guys. Goodbye.